Health authorities have confirmed a rare blood clotting condition is likely related to the Astra Zeneca vaccine. They're adamant the rollout will go on, saying the extremely low risk of side effects is far outweighed by the benefits of protecting the nation against COVID.
After an emergency meeting, a startling revelation.
And it is likely that the case reported yesterday is related to the vaccine.
The case, a 44-year-old man now in a Melbourne hospital, admitted with blood clots days after receiving the AstraZeneca vaccine.
I acknowledge that these reports lead to uncertainty and anxiety.
Despite that, crisis talks won't be held again until Wednesday as investigations and vaccinations continue. Authorities calling for those who've had the jab to monitor themselves for severe symptoms 4 to 20 days after vaccination.
If you've received the AstraZeneca vaccine and experienced symptoms of severe, persistent headache or other worrying symptoms, you should seek medical advice as soon as possible.
The vaccine hasn't been scientifically linked to blood clotting, but in the UK, 7 recipients have died from a rare clotting syndrome. 30 others reported clotting, with 22 reporting a blood clot in the brain. But in Australia, less than 6 in every 1,000 recipients have had an adverse vaccine reaction of any form, and only one has presented with clots.
One case in Australia is nowhere near enough to make any meaningful decisions.
In Brisbane today, another case of community transmission, a close contact of the Northside cluster, as authorities investigate the hospital at the centre of it, moving patients out of a key COVID ward after 2 were infected at separate times in the same room.
We think there could be a problem with that particular room or the environment.
Still, the Sunshine State progressing enough for South Australia to backflip, lifting its hard border with Queensland.
There will be a small number of people who have been to exposure sites in Queensland. Now, they're not allowed out of quarantine.
As anger grows in other states, with returning travellers still stuck in 14-day quarantine, despite the Brisbane lockdown only lasting 3.
I thought, you know, Tassie would respond the same as they did to the news, so it was hard to be stuck here.
Tasmanians offered a reprieve this afternoon.
Right through this, we've taken a sensible and cautious approach.
No such approach in the West.
Our stance in relation to Queensland is similar to the stance that the Premier has taken all along.
New South Wales residents who plan to visit or who have visited Queensland are urged to maintain caution and follow relevant health advice, as we recorded no new local cases in the state.
Despite that, the North Coast remains under temporary restrictions until the end of the long weekend. Amelia Brace, 7 News.